would welcome Keith and Leo for joining us this morning. And let us give them a big round of applause. And before we begin, I ask you to turn off your cell phones or put them on mute. And please, no texting during the service. Would you please join us in our gathering song? There's a wilderness. There's a white page 291 and the Mr. Beck. So please stand.
Thank you. those spots yourself. You did it right until you threw it in the Holy Spirit, when God forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Samuel. Wrath and anger hate the things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins and he did. Forgive your neighbor's injustice, then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the living and the dead. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full." Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, "Pay back what you owe." Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back." But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgive you your entire debt because you begged me. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you?" Then, in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So, will my Heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart? The Gospel of the Lord.
Good afternoon, family. We have with us our brother from the motherland of Nigeria. Our scripture reading for today focuses on God's compassion, God's grace, and God's forgiveness and heart. First reading from the book of Sirach, we're told that wrath and anger are hateful things. We are told to forgive our neighbor's injustice. And when we do, we should pray that our own sins shall be forgiven. Sirach in his wisdom says, if you nourish anger towards another, how can you expect healing from the Lord? Must put pettiness, bitterness aside, keep the commandments and live for God. For the Lord will forgive those who forgive their neighbors. Scripture says, set enmity behind and rely on the mercy of God. We ask that God will overlook our faults as we forgive the sins of others. Truth be told, we know that forgiveness is not easy. Probably one of the most difficult things to do as a human being. I've heard it in the room. You don't know what you did. Lie about it over and over again. They tried to destroy my career. You don't know what the hell I've been through. You know what this has done to me and my family, you'd be I can feel it. I understand a lot of what you understand. Forgiveness is a difficult thing. It is a great idea. It is a powerful commandment. God says you must forgive. But each and every one of us say forgiveness is a lovely idea until we have something to forgive. My daughter was raped. How can you forgive that? My son was killed by gang bangers. How can you forgive that? I will never forgive those people. Thank God, God's ways are not our ways. God's thoughts are not our thoughts. Our second reading, Apostle Paul reminds us that we are the Lord's, and we live and die for the Lord. We live in crazy times. Hurricanes, tsunamis, so-called terrorist bombings, North Korea testing missiles. Your president loses his mind. We know that we belong to Jesus. We've been deceived to believe that the government has the final say in our reality.
Okay.
I stop by here to tell you. Today's gospel, Jesus talks about forgiveness. Peter approached Jesus and said, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered Peter, not seven times, but I tell you, 77 times. Hebrew culture 7 signifies completeness and perfection. Peter probably thought he was being a good disciple, saying, Lord, I'm going to forgive seven times. I'm going to really forgive. But that's not the point Jesus was trying to make. Jesus speaks of God's unlimited forgiveness. He wasn't doing the math, saying 77 times 7 is 490. He wasn't talking in qualitative terms, he was talking in quantitative terms about love and compassion and mercy. This parable teaches us we must forgive in order to be forgiven. Jesus said, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. To myself, this is not easy. We got enemies. We got people we don't really like. That's the truth of it all. I don't like everybody, but I show up.
Amen.
That man and my friend lied about me, talked about me behind my back, the bully who beat me up in grammar school. Do I have to love and forgive him? But it gets even harder. What about the abusive parent, the cheating husband, a cheating wife, the lying businessman, the racist, the rapist, the murderer? Well, I have to forgive them. Not seven times, but 77 times. Jesus taught the apostles to pray. He says, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against you. Do I actually support our request? Forgiveness is not natural to us as human beings. It's so contrary to our human nature. to forgive other people. Person who does not forgive is therefore a person of lacking the godly character, the Christ-like character, to have love and compassion in his heart. I'm just going to give it to you like I said. We black folks are peculiar people. That's what the Bible says. That's how you Bible says. I've been in black people in high school. By me. We forgive everybody on the planet. Come in and kill my whole family. Come and shoot up my whole church. I forgive you over my life. John, who did me like that? My brother who owed me $50. He was dying up to me. Just keep it real. You got to look at yourself. We hold forgiveness to put ourselves in the place of God. God is the ultimate judge. Your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Yes. But if you do not forgive men their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. Yes. Apostle Paul said, be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other just as Christ has forgiven you. God's forgiveness and human beings' forgiveness are related. Today's gospel is King forgives the slaves an extraordinary amount. King went to that man and said, hey man, you owe me a lot of money. His brother got on his knees and begged. He said, man, look here, I'm sorry. Just give me some time, I'm gonna get your money to you. The king moved. Forgave him his debt and set him free. He didn't say, okay, I'm going to give you 6 months. He didn't say, I'm not going to charge you any interest. He set him free. That's like the love of God. That slave, somebody owed him a much, much smaller amount. Went to him and said, you got to give me my money, man. Tell him, say, look here, just give me some time. I'm going to get your money to you. He didn't have any compassion. He threw him in prison. The nerve of him.
Yes.
And how many of us have that? That slave refusing to forgive his brother. He locked him on himself in bondage. His whole heart, it was heavy. And that's how it is when we don't forget. You walk around holding the deepest burdens in the world. And that person you're mad at is probably out somewhere riding a bike, eating a good meal, having some, whatever they're doing, they're having a good time, and you're sitting around hoping. Not 7 times, but 77 times. That's a lot of forgiveness. But the pain of the world, our nation, and our individuals, the pain is great. We need to forgive a lot more. Not only for the world, but for ourselves. We got to forgive those who trespass against us. When we do that, that's a bond of giving that will heal our own hearts. I stop by here to tell you when you forgive, and again, I preach it to myself. Burdens will be lifted from your heart. Your life will be much more alive. Your life will be graceful, whole, and you will be more God-like. I know it ain't easy. Forgiveness, again, is a very difficult thing. future be dictated by the sentiments of the past. We got to let go of some of these thoughts and hatred that keep us confined. I thought about this when I was reading. I'm like, man, this is good, because I got some people. I just said that they think about I'm thank you, Mr. Servant. Love the capacity. We got to practice forgiveness every day. And we begin with recognizing who we are. Recognizing that we have been forgiven. And we are the beneficiaries of God's mercy. How do we forgive? By the grace of God. Webster's dictionary defines grace as simple elegance or refinement and movement. And the Christian belief is the free and unmerited favor of God. Everything we do is by the grace of God. You woke up this morning by the grace of God. You came to home by the grace of God. You breathe by the grace of God. We live by the grace of God. We pray by His grace. We sing by His grace. We dance by His grace. We preach by His grace. And we forgive by His grace. Grace is a good thing. You and I would not be here today if it wasn't for the grace of God. Grace is hearing your word attached to God's name. Y'all didn't hear me on that. Did you ain't got to the books? I'm going to say it again. Grace is a word hearing your name attached to God's name. Grace is being welcomed home after problems too many to count. Grace is making a way out of nowhere. Grace is waiting. You ain't got nothing to eat, but sometimes you got food on your table. Grace is a good. You might be sick right now, but God's got you. You might be going through all kinds of problems, but you sustain by His grace. Hallelujah. Grace is a word deeper than any disease. Grace is the ability to forgive when the people have wronged you. Forgiveness begins with God. In those days when we choose to forgive, our life is somehow uplifted, somehow complete, somehow fulfilled. In those days when we open that anger and that grudge inside, we are just burdened down, beating our own self up. How ridiculous is that? We got to realize that it ain't never about the one that hurt you. It's about God. We don't choose to forgive. God gives us the grace to forgive. We only choose to share the forgiveness that has been granted by the grace of God. Yeah, this is forgiveness is deep. The deep part about the Forgiveness Act, again, is that like the man who was forgiven a great amount, he chose to keep a man in bondage who was only owing him a small amount. That's how a lot of us live. In pettiness. In simplistic ways. How many times must we choose to forgive? 77 times. How many times have you played in your head an argument you didn't have with somebody? How many times have you thought about what you're going to do to that person? How many times have you even got on the phone and called your friend and called that person all kind of names? Truth be told, we are the servant who has been forgiven. God is the great King who forgives humanity. If you want to be forgiven, you better start forgiving. If you want to be loved, you better start loving. If you want to be a friend and have a friend, you better be a friend to somebody. Selfish acts and thoughts. Immaturity, pride and anger, bitterness and hate, all of these add up to serve an awesome God. The good news is that we serve that on-time God who will get, listen to you if you get on your knees and pray to Him. The scripture says that my people who are called by my name will turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven, heal their land. We serve a mighty God. And that is the right way. In one moment, it is gone. Moses was on the run. He was a murderer. He had to confront Pharaoh. He said, let my people go. But God looked at him, forgave him, and made him a deliverer of God's people. David was a mighty king. Oh, but he couldn't take his eyes off of old Bathsheba. He sinned against the Lord, but the Lord forgave. Jonah, thrown into the belly of the whale, he did not want to go and preach to Nineveh, but the Lord said, go and repent, and the Lord lifted him up. We serve a mighty God. If God will deliver them, God will deliver you. This brother from the Eagle tribe, you don't know about that, but you got to come to the books later. Tell him about it. I don't need that. But I stop by here to tell you, if God is with us, who can be against us? We are more than conquerors in Jesus Christ. He's full of truth, grace, and mercy. Jeremiah said, I will forgive their wickedness and remember their sin no more. Thank you, God, for second chances. Thank you, God, for deep love. In the world, great empires come to great leaders rise and fall. Wealth, power, fame, and might are proven to be transient in nature. The only power that is proven to be true and everlasting is the love of God. Love one another. Forgive one another. Love never fails.
Thank you.
pray that the family gathered here this morning today, so you can lead God's blessings and prayers. We ask this in the mighty and the majestic name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
For my brothers and my sisters, my sacrifice and yours, and be made acceptable to God, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the law of the
soul. Look with favor on our supplication, O Lord, and your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that with each an offer to the honor of your name, may serve the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
You invited us, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, most holy, in your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your word, for whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gained for you a holy people. Stretched out his hand and he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so the angels and all the saints, we declare the glory as the one voice we acclaim.
Merit to glory to eternal life.
gracious and grant peace, and you live in the courts of your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
Let us offer each other the sign of God's peace.
Thank you.
new song is a new commandment on page 212 of the Mr.
thank you. Bye.
Seder Rosary every Sunday morning at 7:30. The ministers of care and the extraordinary ministers ask you to save the day and plan to attend the 4th annual Day of Reflection on Saturday, October 14, 2017, from 8:30 a.m. to noon. This year's theme, A Sweet, Sweet Scent, the Aroma of Christ. Our speaker for this ministry is Father Anthony, MSP Pastor of Harper's Christian. See your bulletin for more details. The new church envelopes in the back of the church. Feel free to take the envelope for any shut-in member. If you don't see your box, please call the rectory on Monday during office hours only. Don't forget that today is the 50th anniversary of the Blessed Sacrament. See you all downstairs.
Thank you, Mr. Stewart. You're my brother, Deacon, need to live with a man.
Thank you so much for your warm welcome. I am most delighted to be in your midst and to watch the beautiful choirs. It reminds me of the great crescendo music. So thank you, choir people. And when I'm over there, I want to go to heaven myself. Great. Please, I'm here just a minute about the mission of Bounty Health African Life. It's an institution 501c3 here in the United States that was founded some 3 years, 4 years ago. It's an offspring of the original institution that I founded in Africa, in Nigeria, to assist the poor and the marginalized widows and children who are orphans that are not able to obtain education because of the marginalization and the war that we know about Biafra and Nigeria, which has been since 1967 until today. So I recruit children and put them in an orphanage room where I homeschool them with Reverend Sisters, members of my congregation. And going to have African Life helps it to support the programs that we hold for these children in order to give them skill, not just educational skill, but entrepreneurship skill to be able to sustain themselves in the combat act of the Nigerian, injustice situation, which allows only the rich and the politicians to survive. I myself am an offspring of that survival of the weakest, not the fittest. Today, people supported me. I was able to go to school, and I'm able to serve the church and serve the people of God. I want to help these children, this group of people in the most rural places, to obtain education and to obtain skill, so that if they can't get a job in the government, they can succeed and survive on their own. This is why we're here. And Father Clement, who you all know very well, whose life really resonates with my own way and experience and something that I went through, will be our guest speaker on the 4th of October at the Croatian Franciscans in whatever, you know. So we invite all of you to come who can to support us that brigade. God bless you all and amazing. I'm happy and I hope to visit again, and I hope you will also accept me when I come again. God bless you.
Thank you. blessing of the caddis, Jesus on the road to Emmaus. Your followers were frightened and alone. You had just been put to death on a cross. They met a man on the road leading the way from Jerusalem who told them all about you and what your presence among them meant. They did not realize that the man speaking and walking with them was you, raised from the dead. When their eyes were open and they received the gift of faith, they turned around to spread the word. We ask that you bless all your disciples who now work as catechists in our parishes. Bless them and give them encouragement to their work, that it will have an impact upon the world. We ask this in your name, Jesus, our companion on the road to Emmaus.